We got us a no cooling call. I have no idea what kind of equipment they have or what's going on. So let's go in and see what's happening. Oh yeah, it don't sound very good. Condenser fan motor had stopped. Let's stop and check the motor and these capacitors. Oh, if you hear me talking, I'm doing a little video, okay? I'm not crazy.
Oh, no, I understand.
Wonder I didn't just get shocked. All right, that's supposed to be 45. I got 43. got 11 on that one. And that's supposed to be 12.5. Let me check it one more time. None of those are low enough to make it stop. Let's take a look at that motor. Like I see a little oil coming out. Y'all see how stiff those bearings are? Yep, that means a new condenser fan motor. I'm gonna disconnect all of this. All right, it looks like we got a 1/3 horsepower. That capacitor is supposed to be a 10. 1/3 horsepower, 1055 RPM. Let me go see what I got. I got half of mine to go get the factory motor if they have it. All right, because I needed a dual capacitor as well, I did have a rescue motor, but it's going to cost about as much as an OEM motor. So we're going to get a dual capacitor and a motor for this. I'm on my way to get that now. All right, we're back and we have a motor and capacitor. We'll be right back. How about that? That has gotten hot. This is my start for my compressor. That was a little bit loose. All right, I'm gonna pull this wire off and replace it. Whoops, man. As y'all see, that has gotten a little bit hot. You see the discoloration? I didn't realize the sun was right in your eyes. The discoloration right there, and it broke. So we're gonna replace that. This is the spade that got hot, so I'm gonna use the other one. All right. All right, let's put power to it. Looks like we've had some visitors in here. Thank you. right, let's see how we're doing. Pretty good. All right, let's check our amp draw. Guys, that was a pretty normal call, a motor change. Those are the kinds of calls that pay the bills. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.